So this past weekend, I was in Vegas and I just knew I had to go to Omega Mart because I saw it on TikTok. I saw this video and I was like, what is this place? It looks magical. I need to go. This video is about my experience there, what I recommended to you, and what I thought of it. Here we go. I went on a Sunday. So the place opens at 10 o'clock. We got there at 11 o'clock. It's timed entry. So you pick a time, whatever you need to go, and you have like a 15 minute grace period. So we got there at 11 and it was already a line. Like, it's busy. And obviously the weekends are peak time. So I would advise going during the week because it's not overcrowded, but it's definitely a lot of people walking around in there. Omega Mart, how would I even describe it? It's an immersive experience, okay? You are in there, there's different worlds to explore, there's a storyline to explore, there's art to explore. It's just beautifully designed. It's so well done. And it's just an experience. It is a beautiful experience. It's located in Area 15, which is really close to the Strip. It took us less than 10 minutes to get there from around like the Venetian Encore area. And they have an open parking lot. It's very easy. Signage is clear. You know where to go. As soon as you walk in, you'll see the big Omega sign right there. It's very clear. So you get in line and they let you in. And at first you see this big, looks like a grocery store. But when you get up close, you see this is not regular items, that they all have like some of them have funny names. It's very clever, it's very detail oriented, and it's just so impressive. And so you feel like you're in an alternate universe, like if you were underneath a real grocery store, this is what the alternate dimension grocery store would look like. Like, the storyline is that a portal was opened, and so you want to find the secret doors, find the secret stairways. It is a giant space. When you walk into the store, it's small, but then there's secret doors and secret stairs to go to, and that'll take you through the rest of the space. And so because I saw it on TikTok, I knew where the one secret door was, but you'll see everyone walking through it, so it's not really a secret. You will literally see everybody going through this door. So you walk in there, and then there's so many different rooms, you guys. There's so many rooms, and all the lighting effects. I will say, I'm surprised they didn't have like lighting warning, a strobe effect warning, because it was a lot of simulation coming at you all at once. I was fine with it, but I could see how people who are photosensitive would be concerned, okay? So I don't know, if that is not your jam, then this is not your jam, okay? There's so many different areas to go into. There's like a factory type of theme, and there's like office space, and then there's just this magical, looks like just a magical fairy tale land, and you just kind of walk through, and there's different tunnels you can go through. Adults can do it too. I found myself crawling through a couple tunnels, and there are slides you can go down. I went down two slides, and I will tell you, I can't remember the last time I went down a slide, and I don't know if I need to ever go down a slide again. Like, adults could go down, but I'm like, this is a kid thing, because the way I landed at the bottom, it was a little hard. I don't know if big people should be going down this, but we did it. We did it. And it was fun. I would say the biggest thing, like, you really do feel like a child again. And yes, there are kids running around, and it's so much fun. And I think there's two experiences that you can have while you're there. So when you enter, they give you this little card. It's called a boop card. And it looks like this. And you get one per party. And they tell you wherever you see this little design, you hold the card up to it. And then something pops up on the screen and it tells you what to do. So this is part of like the scavenger hunt. If you want a journey, if you want a mission, use this and you tap it at all the different parts and it kind of tells you what to do. There's like different tasks you need to complete in other areas. And so we did this most of the time. I will say, if I was by myself, I don't think I would have done this. I didn't really care that much, but my boyfriend loves like storylines like this, and it's easy to follow, and it does make it more of an adventure. But if you just like the stroll, if you just like to go through like art experiences and just kind of do your own thing and sit down and enjoy the lighting and everything, then this might be a lot, because we were there 3 hours and doing this. And it was like in between the times where he was like going on the mission, I was like, oh, let's go down the slide, let's do this. Like, I was kind of trying to do both. And I will say, on the weekends, it's a lot to do both, because there's a lot of people, and a lot of people are trying to do that journey scavenger hunt situation. There's only a certain number of places where you're supposed to boop, and there's lines, and it just kind of makes it like, oh, okay, this, I would rather just walk around. But it was something to focus on. But if you're just a free spirit, you just like to, and you get to interact with all the set pieces, so like you can touch the books, and there was like an apothecary room, and you can mess with stuff. Like, it's fine, it's very interactive, which I really enjoyed about that. And there was telephones ringing, you could pick up the phone, you could call people. It was very cool. It was very cool. I felt like a kid again, and it was so much fun. I felt like I was in a different world, and I would highly recommend it. Honestly, I would highly recommend it. If you're in Vegas, get away from the Strip for a little bit and go into this alternate universe. It is so unique. This was the most fun I've had in a while, and I completely think you should do it. Just decide which track you want to go. If you want to do the hunt, if you want to do the adventure, cool. it's kind of hard to do both. It's like, do I want to sit in this flower room and just relax? Or do I want to be like, wait, what's the next mission? Like, it's a lot to kind of juggle at the same time. And I honestly felt like we were there for 3 hours, and I felt kind of rushed on time because we had to drive back to LA the same day. And I didn't want to get back too late and everything. And so I was aware of the time, but we could have been there. We could have been there all afternoon. We could have been there a long time. There's so much to see. And I know that apparently there's a hidden bar. I didn't find it. I don't know where it was. I know there's places we didn't see. Like, it's huge. It's so big. I would definitely say do not go if you're on a time crunch. Don't just, oh, let's just stop in really quick. It's not a stop in real quick kind of place. If you have time, just enjoy yourself. But I would definitely recommend it. It was a wonderful experience. That's it. I just want to share that with you guys. I think it's relatively new. I think a lot of people might not know about it. But yes, if you're in Vegas, go. But that's it, you guys. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.